गुड मॉर्निंग टू माई ऑल डियर स्टूडेंट्स. आवर चैप्टर नंबर 8 इज गोइंग ऑन विच इज मैग्नेटिज्म एंड मैग्नेटिक प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ सब्सटेंसेस. ओके, इन दिस चैप्टर वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ ए बार मैग्नेट एंड सम डेफिनेशंस ऑफ ए बार एंड some properties of a magnetic lines of a forces. In this sequence, today we discuss about a new property of a magnetic field lines, which is a neutral point. What is neutral point? Simply, the point around a magnet. Suppose this is a bar magnet. This is N pole and this S pole. Then the points around a bar magnet at which magnetic field intensity is equal to zero. Then these points are called neutral points. Okay. We know that the direction of Earth magnetic field. The direction of a Earth magnetic field is south to north. Okay, suppose these are the magnetic field lines. Inward direction and this is outward direction. These are the magnetic field lines which is start from north pole and end at a south pole. Okay, and we know that. Suppose this is south, geographical south, this is north, this is east and west. Horizontal component of Earth magnetic field is south to north. Then in this condition, if the magnitude of both, this is BH, magnitude of a both components, both magnetic field is equal and we can see these are in opposite direction, then here some points are found where magnetic field lines are not present. It means magnetic field intensity is equal to zero and these points are known as neutral point. Okay, so the point where the magnetic field due to a magnet is equal and opposite to the horizontal component of Earth magnetic field, then this point are called neutral point. Okay, it means at neutral points magnetic field intensity is equals to zero. These points are the position of these points are depend on the position of a bar magnet. Okay, so first is when south pole of a magnet is towards the geographical north. First condition is when south pole of magnet is toward the geographical north. Suppose this is compass, this is north pole, this is south, this west and east. Okay, now if we have a bar magnet and we kept this bar magnet in such a way, south pole of magnet is toward the geographical north. This is north side, then this is south pole and this is north pole. Okay, and we know that magnetic field lines start from north pole to south pole. Okay, so in this condition, the magnetic field lines represent like as. These are the magnetic field lines. Okay, these are the magnetic field lines and like this. The direction of this north to south. Okay, now we know that horizontal component of Earth magnetic field is south to north, means in this direction, direction of BH in this direction. Okay, so here the magnetic field of Earth like S, but at these points the magnetic field, this magnetic field is turned into in this direction because of here this magnetic field of the magnet is active. So this magnetic field ions are move in this direction. Okay, similarly here, so in this situation two points are found. At these points magnetic field ions are not present. It means magnetic field intensity is equals to zero. So we can say when south pole of magnet is towards the geographical north, then in this condition both on the axial line, this is the axial line, on both side two neutral points, first is N1 and another one is N2. Two neutral points are obtained. Okay, first situation is this. Second is when north pole of magnet is towards the geographical north. Okay, suppose north pole of magnet is towards the geographical north, means this is a north direction of Earth. Then in this situation, if we kept a bar magnet in such a way, the north pole is pointed in the geographical north in this way. Okay, and again we know that magnetic field lines start from north to south. Okay, suppose in initial condition magnetic field lines are start from this pole, then magnetic field lines जो है वो north से south turn करेंगे. ठीक है, इस condition में here जो BH की direction है वो इस direction में, इसके इफेक्ट में ये इधर टर्न ना करके इस साइड में टर्न करेंगे. देन इन दिस कंडीशन द फॉर्म ऑफ मैग्नेटिक फील्ड लाइंस इन दिस वे लाइक दिस. ओके, लाइक दिस. नाउ एट साउथ पोल द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड लाइंस इन दिस वे एंड horizontal component of Earth like this. This is the magnetic field lines of Earth, means BH, in such a way. Okay, here we can easily see that two points, these are the two points here, magnetic field lines are absent. Okay, so in this condition two neutral points N1 and N2 are found at the equatorial line. This is the non-axial line, or we can say equatorial line. Okay, third condition, third is when the magnet is kept vertical. Okay, in this condition we have two conditions. First is if the north pole lies on lower side, and another one is if south pole lies on lower side. First is if they place the magnet in vertical direction such that its north pole, this is the north pole of the magnet, bar magnet, so and such that its north pole lies on lower side, then In this condition, the magnetic field lines, this is the south to north, and direction of BH is south to north. In this condition, firstly, अगर यहां से स्टार्ट होती हैं मैग्नेटिक फील्ड लाइंस, देन BH के इफेक्ट में ये इधर टर्न करेंगे, इधर टर्न होंगी इस डायरेक्शन में, देन मैग्नेटिक फील्ड लाइंस वी गेट इन दिस वे. ओके, देन इन दिस कंडीशन दिस इज द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड लाइंस ऑफ बार मैग्नेट एंड दीज आर द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड लाइंस ऑफ BH. देन ए पॉइंट, दिस पॉइंट P, we found this point P is a neutral point. Its position lies, you can see that this is the south direction of the point. So we can say its position lies south to north pole. Okay, in other condition, if we place south pole in lower position, then in this situation we got another neutral point P, and which is placed north to south pole of the magnet. Okay, these are some conditions about the neutral point. Now we study a new topic, which is magnetic dipole and magnetic dipole moment. First is magnetic dipole. This is magnetic dipole. What is magnetic dipole? In first chapter, we study electric dipole. What is electric dipole? A system which is made by two charges, which is equal in magnitude and opposite in nature, are placed at small distance. Then this arrangement is called electric dipole. Similarly, here an arrangement of two magnetic dipoles, two magnetic poles, suppose these are two poles, this N and this S, and these are placed a limited distance L. Then in this condition we can say an arrangement of two magnetic poles of equal and opposite strength, here we can say equal and opposite strength, separated by a finite distance, then this arrangement is called magnetic dipole. Okay, in other words, we can say in first chapter we study, if we place a electric dipole in external electric field, then due to this external electric field, this dipole rotate. Okay, similarly here a body which is placed in an external magnetic field, if this body rotate, then this body is called magnetic dipole. Okay, in other words, we can say a bar magnet is rotated in a magnetic field as like electric dipole in electric field. So this bar magnet is called magnetic dipole. Some example of magnetic dipole, first is this bar magnet, and another one is current loop. Current loop is also a magnetic dipole. Okay. Now, next is magnetic dipole moment. Magnetic dipole moment. Okay. Magnetic dipole moment for a coil, we can say, suppose if we have a coil of radius of entrance and a cross sectional area A, and current flowing, this current I flowing through this coil, and if the normal of the plane of the coil is at an angle theta with the magnetic field, then in this situation torque tau will be produced, and this torque tau is equals to, we know that from previous chapter, NIAB sine theta. Here tau is the torque, N number of turns in coil I, current flowing through this coil A, cross sectional area of coil B, magnetic field theta, angle between plane of coil and magnetic field. This is equation number 1. And from chapter 1st, we know that in the electric field, if we place an electric dipole in external electric field with theta angle, then in this situation, electric torque tau is equals to PE sine theta. This is equation number 2. Here tau is the torque, E is electric field, theta is angle. Then comparing equation 1 and 2, tau is equals to tau, theta is equals to theta, B, here magnetic field, here electric field. Here P is electric dipole moment. Electric dipole moment. So the remaining part of this equation is equal to magnetic dipole moment. Magnetic dipole moment. So magnetic dipole moment, which is represented by capital M for a coil, is equals to NIA. This is the magnetic dipole moment. This is a vector quantity. So in vector form, M vector is equals to NIA vector. Okay, this is the vector quantity. So the direction of this magnetic dipole moment along to axis of a magnetic dipole. Okay, or we can say perpendicular to current loop. Perpendicular to plane of current loop. Okay. And unit of this magnetic dipole moment M. Unit M is unitless, I current ampere into unit of this area is meter square. So unit of magnetic dipole moment is ampere into meter square. Okay. Now put this value in this equation, then tau is equals to MB sine theta. MB sine theta. Now we applying some conditions. If B magnetic field is equals to 1 Tesla. Tesla is the unit of magnetic field, and theta is equals to 90 degree. So sine 90 is equals to 1. So tau is equals to M. So tau is equals to M. So we can say the torque on magnetic dipole which is placed perpendicular to a uniform magnetic field, perpendicular to a uniform magnetic field of a unit strength, is equal to the magnetic dipole moment. Okay, this is the magnetic dipole moment for a coil, for a current carrying loop. Now, magnetic dipole moment of a bar magnet. Okay, suppose we have a bar magnet of effective length L. This is N, S, and effective length L. And the pole strength of this bar magnet is M. Then the product of a pole strength of any pole of this bar magnet and effective length of this bar magnet is called magnetic moment of bar magnet. Magnetic moment is denoted by capital M. So capital M is equals to the product of a M means the product of a pole strength of any pole and effective length. This is the magnetic moment of bar magnet. This is a vector quantity, so M vector is equals to M into N. From this equation, again, unit of this magnetic dipole moment is unit of pole strength is ampere into meter, and a unit of length is also meter. So unit of this magnetic moment is ampere into meter square. Okay, this is the unit, and this is a vector quantity. So direction of this magnetic dipole is in the direction of L vector. direction of L vector. And we know that what is the direction of effective length? The direction of effective length is south pole to north pole. So direction of magnetic moment is also in south to north pole. Okay, this is the magnetic dipole moment of bar magnet. Now we take some conditions. First is, if a bar magnet is cut, suppose this is a bar magnet of effective length L and a pole strength is M. Now if we cut this bar magnet perpendicular to its length, this is length, and we cut in perpendicular to length, then we get two equal parts. This is N, this is S. This is N, this is S. Okay, in this way, in this condition, pole strength remains same. It means this is M, 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 M. But effective length is half to its original length. Then in this condition, magnetic moment of each part, which is denoted by capital M dash, is equals to multiplication of a M into effective length. Here effective length is L by 2. Okay, and this is original magnetic dipole. M is equals to M into L. So this M into L replaced by capital M. So M dash is equals to capital M by 2. It means in this condition, the magnetic dipole moment of each part will be half of the original magnetic dipole moment. Second is, again, suppose we have a bar magnet of length L. This is length L. Okay, and a pole strength is small m. Now, if this bar magnet is cut along to its axis, it means in this way, then we get two equal part of same length like this. Okay, in this condition, length of the bar magnet remains same, but pole strength will be half. It means M by 2, M by 2. This is M by 2, this is M by 2. And this is L, and this is also L. In this condition, magnetic moment of each part M dash is equals to product of a pole strength of any pole into effective length. But M into L is equals to capital M. So M dash is equals to capital M by 2. Okay. In this way, a magnetic moment of each part is half of the original magnetic field. Third condition, if a bar magnet, suppose again, this is a bar magnet of effective length L. Okay, suppose this bar magnet of length L is bent to make a semicircle like this, semicircle of radius small r. This is a semicircle which is made by this bar magnet, this N pole, S pole. This length is L, but radius of this semicircle is small r. Then now in this condition, effective length and this equals to 2r diameter, 2r. In this way, M dash equals to M into 2r. But this is half circumference, and half circumference pi r is equals to, this equals to length L. So here r is equals to L upon pi. Put the value of r in this equation, then M dash is equals to M into 2L upon pi. But M into L is equals to capital M. So M dash is equals to 2M upon pi. In this condition, the new magnetic moment of this semicircle is equals to, in this condition. Fourth condition is, if a magnetic moment of two magnets, which is m1 vector and m2 vector, are at an angle theta, are perhaps at angle theta in this way. Suppose this is a bar magnet, this n, this s, and m1 vector, and suppose this is another bar magnet, this is n, this is s, and a magnetic moment of this bar magnet is m2 vector, and these are placed at theta angle. When in this condition, the resultant magnetic moment, magnitude of magnetic moment, which is by which is determined by vector laws of two vectors. Okay, then the magnitude of this resultant is denoted by m vector, this n, and this is n s. So magnitude of m vector is equals to m1 square plus m2 square plus 2m1 m2 cos of theta. This is the magnitude of resultant magnetic moment of two vectors, of two magnets. Okay students, these are some conditions of a bar magnet, magnetic dipole of a bar magnet. Okay, clear? Next part of this chapter we will study in our next class. So this class, carefully learn it and remember it. Okay, and if you like this video, then please like it and maximally share it, and if you have any doubts, and give your feedbacks in comment box. Thank you.